Hi everyone, Ron Crider reporting for duty today. It is Saturday afternoon, Super Bowl weekend. It's 1:09 when I'm putting this first little piece together. And first thing I want to let you know is that I do have four little short videos that I have put together, little news bites that I've picked up around the state. Some of them are fairly interesting. I'll tell you in advance what they are. The first one has to do with the Vatican. Is it okay for Catholics to get the vaccination for COVID-19? Well, first, the bottom line is both of the popes have already received the vaccination, but they have more or less given their blessing on the fact that it's okay to get the vaccine. There are issues relating to it, and she'll tell you about that. Then Vero Beach has a new way to sign up for vaccinations. There's a little video on that as well. I did it. It was very easy to do. It was actually easier than the public's one. Oh, the next one is a couple who tried desperately to sign up for the vaccines and actually were able to do it. I thought it was kind of an interesting little thing. And then the final one is on the COVID variants, and there's a doc in Orlando who is going to tell you a little bit about that. So let's get rolling here. First, let's get into the one regarding the Vatican and Catholic folks, and then we'll move into the next. Stand by. Here we go.
Over at the Vatican, religious leaders have declared the COVID-19 vaccine morally acceptable. The announcement stands in contrast to earlier guidance from some church leaders in the U.S. The Vatican's watchdog says that Roman Catholics can get the vaccine, which is based on research that used cells from aborted fetuses. It said that, quote, the morality of vaccination depends not only on the duty to protect one's own health, but also on the duty to pursue the common good, end quote.
Alrighty, here's the one I picked up on Indian River County and its new vaccination system. As I said, it was very easy to sign up for. It's at least what I think it does for you is once you have signed up, then it will contact you when vaccinations will be available. At least I hope that's what it's going to do. We shall see. Stand by. Here we go.
Well, Indian River County has launched a new COVID-19 vaccine registration system. People who are 65 and older or work in healthcare can sign up to be put on that wait list. Appointments will then be scheduled based on availability of the vaccine and the date that the resident actually registered. If you can't make an appointment, you will remain at the top of the list, they say, and then be offered a new appointment when the next vaccines are available.
All right, I thought this was an interesting little news bit. This couple decided that they wanted to sign up for the vaccination, and they tried and tried and tried, and guess what? Like winning the lottery. They were able to do it. Check this out. I think you'll like it.
For weeks now, some eligible Americans have made countless calls, checked websites every day, and waited on long lines trying to get a vaccine, coming up empty time and time again. Today, we're joined by one couple whose effort seems to have just paid off within the last hour or so, but it's taken a lot of patience. Charles and Carmen Leone are joining us now to share their story. Charles and Carmen, thank you so much for being here with us. You know, we've been talking to so many reporters, asking them about the difficulties of this process and how hopeless it can feel at times. And I'm so grateful that you're here to share it with us firsthand. But first, let's start with the best news, your breaking news, that you finally had some success this morning. I think it was just in the last couple hours with booking your vaccine appointment in Florida where you live. Is that right?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
So tell me what happened this morning.
Well, I got on about 5 to 7 and I waited and the site wasn't moving. It was like frozen. And then all of a sudden, I think we had like maybe a half hour more to go on the site. And it finally said book appointment. And I was ecstatic.
Yay. And now it's scheduled. Go ahead.
After so many days trying, we finally got through. It's like hitting the lottery.
Oh, that's such a good way to put it. So, yeah, tell me about the process to get here. How hard has it been to get that appointment?
Well, we've been getting up at 6:30 every morning, 5:30 actually, every morning, and getting on at 6 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And we've had no success. Mm-hmm. And it's been very frustrating. We have friends of ours that still haven't been able to get on.
Right, and we keep hearing all these stories now about the variant of COVID-19 as it comes out of Africa and the UK, and how the drugs that we are going to be taking will be affected by it and how they will work and are they going to be effective. Anyway, here's a doc up in Orlando that's going to explain that to us.
And today I had the chance to speak with an infectious disease physician, asking him a variety of questions on COVID-19 and the new variants. Dr. Jared Fox is an infectious disease physician at Orlando Health. who sat down with News 6 and allowed us to pick his brain. We asked him a number of questions, starting with this one. Will people have to get inoculated every year for this, like the flu shot? Or will this be something where you get the initial vaccine and then get a booster every few years?
Right now, we don't know. Most of the vaccine candidates out there, they're working on boosters towards a number of the variants. They may not need them, but they're going ahead and producing them just in case we find out that we do need a booster shot for them. Right now, they think that most of the vaccines are effective enough against the South African strain that we may not need the booster.
Are younger people more susceptible to the new variants of the virus?
As of right now, we don't think that, there's one population that's any more susceptible than the other strains. It's just more contagious in general.
Are the vaccines that are out there right now effective against all of these variants?
The Moderna and the Pfizer vaccines, they've done studies. It is still effective. It's less effective against the South African strain than it is the UK strain, but it is still effective.
Right now, Dr. Fox tells me he is not overly concerned about the new variants, adding that hand washing, masking, and social distancing are still good ways to protect yourself.
Yeah, we're hearing about a new case in Central Florida. Ezzie Castro is at the health department in Orange County.
Health officials say the resident may have contracted the mutation during a trip to Mexico. And at this point, almost all Central Florida counties have reported variant cases, which is why health officials say it's important to get people vaccinated now more than ever.
We confirm that the UK variant has been detected in our county.
Dr. Alpino with the Florida Department of Health says an Orange County resident has tested positive for the UK COVID-19 variant. He said the man had recently traveled outside the country and may have gotten the virus there.
He was acquired probably in Mexico during a trip, and we have traced and investigated some of the individuals in the trip, and some are on stay as well.
According to the CDC, more than 600 cases have been reported across the country. Florida nearly has 200 variant cases. Dr. Pino says it's now a race against time to get more people vaccinated, because while the vaccines appear to be effective against the UK strain, other variants are more resistant.
Already got to put the glasses on for this one. I guess you want to know what the weather is going to be like over there in Tampa, St. Petersburg for the Super Bowl. Most of the potential rainfall is expected to fall early on Sunday, though there is still a slight chance of precipitation throughout the night and into the daytime. The radar shows the strongest chance of rain as well as thunderstorms on Saturday afternoon before kickoff. In other words, you can count on some scattered showers over the weekend. It's just a matter of whether it's going to fall before or during the Super Bowl. I gotta tell you, that's not much of a weather forecast, is it? It's not exactly what you wanted to hear, but it does tell you one thing. There is a possibility that some rain could be lurking around over there for this Super Bowl. So it'll only make it even more exciting. Personally, I think it's going to be one of the better Super Bowls that we've ever seen. But what am I to say? I'm not the kind of Super Bowl fan, sports fan, as Dr. Miley Snell is, who seems to think that this is not going to be that much of a game. But we'll see. Okay, here we go. Oh, and by the way, what's the purpose of this whole thing? The whole video here is to give you the numbers for the entire state of Florida for the past 24 hours. Now, it's 1:44 when I'm doing this right this second, so I don't know what the numbers are. But I will know them in about an hour, and when I do, they'll be tagged right onto the end of this. Thank you very much for watching. And by the way, don't forget to push the like. In case you didn't get that, it's push the like button. That's what I was trying to say. Sorry about that. Okay, here we are in the numbers department. Right now it is 4:17 in the afternoon, Saturday afternoon on Super Bowl weekend. And the numbers are down as usual on the weekends. I guess that's good news, but it's probably there's some reason why they are, because they always seem to be down on the weekends. 146 new deaths reported in the past 24 hours in the entire state of Florida. That's down by 65 over yesterday. Yesterday, we had 211. Positives, 7,486. That's down by 4,057. Yesterday, we had 11,543. Now, as far as vaccinations are concerned for the entire state of Florida, we've so far vaccinated 2,448,711, and in the past 24 hours, we've vaccinated 81,352. Not bad. I wasn't one of them, but I do have a reservation. I got Publix for Thursday, so I do have a place to get my vaccination, and thanks to Dr. Kadadaday, who somehow or other was patient enough to do it, more patient than I. Alrighty, let's take a look at Miami-Dade. Miami-Dade, 15 new deaths to report in the past 24 hours, 1,470 new positives, and the number of vaccinations in Dade County in the past 24 hours, 3,685. In Broward County, Fort Lauderdale, 12 new deaths to report, 797 new positives, 3,869 new vaccinations in the past 24 hours. In the Palm Beach County area, no new deaths to report. Hooray! No new deaths in Palm Beach County. 531 new positives up there, though, and 4,946 new vaccinations in the past 24 hours in the Palm Beaches. In Orange County, Orlando, no new deaths to report. 394 new positives and 1,724 new vaccinations in the Orlando area. 9 new deaths to report in Brevard County, that's Melbourne, 165 new positives, 1,534 new vaccinations in Brevard County. In St. Lucie County, 7 new deaths to report, 91 new positives in the past 24 hours, 815 new vaccinations in St. Lucie County. That would be Fort Pierce. And then in Martin County, 2 new deaths to report, 29 new positives. Martin County is the Stewart area, 688 new vaccinations there. And in Indian River County, 6 new deaths to report in the past 24 hours, 43 new positives, 839 new vaccinations here in Indian River County. As we scoot down here just a little bit and take a look at the zip codes for Indian River County, zip code 32948, these are all going to be positives in the past 24 hours. So zip code 32948, no new positives in zip code 32948. 8 new positives in zip code 32958, 6 new in zip code 32960, 32960 is Vero Beach proper, 8 in zip code 32962, 2 in zip code 32963, that's us here on the Barrier Island, 32966 had 5, 32967 had 9, 32968 had 5. Those are the number of new positives in Indian River County. We're going to go down here and take a look at the 7-day moving averages. This number is a little better than it was yesterday. Yesterday it was 188.43. Today that number is 178.14. Those are the number of people who passed away each day for the past 7 days as a result of COVID-19. So the number did come down a little bit. Okay, we have a bit of a new looking chart down here for you to take a look at. Now, what I'm going to do today is I'm going to have to reduce this down a little bit, make it a little bit smaller so you can see the whole thing. And let's say I don't like that. Let's go back to the, this will be easier for you to see. Here we go. Okay, for the entire United States, the United States had administered 38,465,607. Those are the number of doses that have been totally administered in the entire United States. Daily, they've administered 1,359,505, and they've used up 65.9% of the number of vaccines they have on hand at the moment. Now, as you know, these numbers all change daily because they get new supply of vaccines in, and then that number starts going up and down and so forth. But that's what they have on hand right now. They don't have enough to do everybody twice, but they do have 65.9 left. All righty. Take a look at Texas. Same deal in Texas. Texas did 101,000 vaccinations, 101,557. In the past 24 hours, they've used up 69.1% of their vaccines. California vaccinated 160,197. They've used up 62% of theirs. Florida has vaccinated 81,352 total number of people. They've used up 64% of their vaccines. Rhode Island has vaccinated 3,414. They've used up 63% of theirs. Colorado, 19,975. They've used up 66% of theirs. Wisconsin, 30,549 in the past 24 hours. They've used up 74.6% of their vaccines. Minnesota, 27,550 vaccinations. 68% of their vaccines have been used. New Jersey, 28,308 in the past 24 hours. These are the vaccinations now. 64.5% of the vaccines have been used in their supply. And in New York, 65,490 people were vaccinated in the past 24 hours. 66.2% of the vaccines were used there. In New York City now, this is a weird number. So I don't know what the story is on this number. I don't trust it. We are going to disregard New York City because this is a strange-looking number here, and I'm not exactly sure how it got there and exactly what it means. We'll go back here and take a look at these deaths. So, in the United States, 48 hours ago, 3,665 people passed away as a result of COVID. In Texas, 439. California, 633. Florida, 211. Rhode Island, 3. Colorado, 27. Wisconsin, 28. Minnesota, 22. New Jersey, 93, and in New York, 161. These are the number of people who passed away as a result of COVID in the past 48 hours. I do have some 24-hour numbers that are, you'll see them over here. Take, for example, but they're not all here, and I don't like to give you numbers until I have a complete set of numbers. All righty, let's jump up here and take a look at the global view. These are the really big numbers now. 26,890,360 people have gotten COVID-19 since we started keeping count of these way back in March. USA deaths, 461,681, number of people who passed away here in the United States as a result of COVID-19. And global cases, over 105 million people, over 105,675 people contracted COVID-19 since we started keeping track of these. And as far as the number of people are concerned who passed away in the entire world, 2,306,107. Alrighty, folks, so those are the numbers for today. I'm going to do the shout-outs tomorrow. I might as well do the shout-outs because that'll happen right before the Super Bowl. And after that, nobody's going to look at this. Probably won't look at this for a couple of days because you'll all be either celebrating or crying. I don't know if you noticed, but I believe the mayor of Tampa went to the Tampa airport to meet the mayor of Kansas City, I believe. Of course it's Kansas City. And she showed up with apparently dozens and dozens and dozens of boxes of Kleenex because she wanted them to have something to wipe their tears when the Tampa beats Kansas City. Yep, that's what's going on over there. They're thinking about changing the name of Tampa to Champa if they become the champions. The Buccaneers become the champions. Personally, I think it's going to be a really good game. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much for watching today. I hope you have a very blessed and safe Saturday. Remember, no partying now. We're not going to want this thing to start spreading. We don't want another big spike like we got after New Year's and after Christmas and after Thanksgiving and after the 4th of July. Let's not make it happen for Super Bowl. Let's keep this one down. Show everybody that we can actually be obedient for a change, all right? See you back here again tomorrow. Have a blessed day. Ron Crider signing off.